My name is Vera Strymkovskaya. I am human rights defender from Belarus.
Vera graduated as a lawyer from the university in Minsk. That's the capital of what is now Belarus, but what was then a part of the Soviet Union. She soon found herself in an interesting time of her country's history.
And it was time when we create a new vision for Belarus, because it became perestroika time. I spoke in a difficult TV programs, and I wrote difficult articles in the newspapers, and because it was a little bit time before perestroika, it was quite popular between young people to discuss that situation. For people it was necessary also to understand why Belarus is the last country in all Europe which still have capital punishment.
Apart from speaking on the television, Vera also worked as a lawyer, and step by step she became a human rights defender. And when her country reached a new step in time, she found herself in the very center of attention.
It came time when the Soviet Union separated in 1991, and we, Belarus, became an independent country. Our legal system became a new legal system, not a part of Soviet Union legal system. And as a lawyer, as a human rights defender, I get my first and very special case, because it was a presidential election, and we was involved to the process of elected the first president to our free, democratic, independent Belarus. And it was different candidates. Of course, it was members of Communist Party, which was before, and people don't trust them or would love to see someone new and very who will protect their rights and who will be against corruption. And it was such a person which came with two charisma. It was Lukashenko. He spoke about he don't like corruption and he will do everything for it. Belarus will be free and happy land, and people trust him. And he was actually a leader for many Belarusians. And I was his lawyer when he was he was a candidate in a presidential election. I didn't know him. Members of his team just come and ask me, are you not afraid of to protect or defend such a person who is now in a candidate in the presidential elections? For me, it was normal. I know how to protect his rights, and I was his lawyer, and I won a case. And then he became first president of Belarus.
As I think you can hear in the tone of Vera's voice, it was a very exciting time for Belarus. They all had big hopes for the future, but I think we all know what happened next.
26 years he is president of Belarus, still first and one president of Belarus. How we can use it? We was full of dreams, we was full of our hopes, we was full of energy to create a new country, a new system, and became a part of Europe. But it was not like we dreamt.
Lukashenko quickly started a process to change the constitution. He became more and more authoritarian until he became a dictator. All the while, Vera continued her work as a human rights defender.
It was very difficult because I was alone in that process, and I was alone against a big part of military system or not democratic system, which created all that circumstances in the case. And I understood that, but I couldn't do anything. I just spoke openly for people who was involved in that situation, and to public and to newspapers.
People started noticing her and her important work, and she was invited to speak about human rights all over the world.
When I was invited to White House and met Bill Clinton and Hillary Clinton, and I get prize from American lawyers for my human rights activity. And then I was invited to Germany, and the Association of German Judges gave me a prize. And I met President Johannes Rau. Then I met a lot of famous leaders like Dalai Lama or Bishop Tutu. I was traveling around all the world, met a lot of people. It was time when I just was very active, when I create activity, when I was like a star. It was like a show in my life. I was not just a traveler and speak about human rights defender. No, I continue to be very active human rights defender in my country, and I protected a lot of famous opposition leader.
All of her work put her in quite a dangerous situation.
And I feel always pressure and harassment from other side. I was not accepted in a lawyers association because they always tried to punish me, to push me, to push me out. And for one side, I was protected people, and I gave all my energy to that, to them. But another side, I protected myself because I always was under the pressure of government, and it's a lot of criminal cases against me. It's, I have here, at last they took my car as a punishment. They punished me to pay some straf. No, it was time when we have not so much to eat, and it was difficult in our normal life.
Since Vera had managed to earn the respect of the international press and the human rights organizations, she felt somewhat safe.
Different human rights organizations which knows about me, they sent a lot of letters, and I have support letters from different countries, from different human rights organizations, from different lawyers organizations in the world. They try to protect me in their ways. They make for me like umbrella with their letters which they sent to Lukashenko, to his administration. I think they all helped me in not to be punished as a lawyer, not to be probably disappeared like famous politicians in Belarus, because we have in Belarus it's five very famous politicians who was disappeared in that time, and we still don't know where they are, what's happened with those people. I feel that I'm not free. I feel that I'm not protected.
Things escalated and she felt more and more unsafe in Belarus. She finally escaped to Sweden when something happened to her friend.
My friend Stanislav Markelov, he was famous lawyer in Russia. He was killed in Red Square that day. And it was like a signal for me. Many times I think about why. Was it right or was it not right that I came to Sweden and now I live like another life? But then I understood, because I believe and I trust to God. I understood that we have in our life different ways how to go. First, I was very active to help people with my experience, with my energy, with everyday activity, with my job and with my ideas, my education. And now I can do it in another way. I have time to think about, I have time to write about it, I have time to tell people and probably to share with another people. It's also important to share with people your philosophy and your understanding of life, for next generation will live life with that ideas, with that experience, with that, with my understanding of why and how.
I think that what she's saying here is so important. We need to learn from the generations that came before us. We have to look at their experiences, what went wrong and what went right, and we can use that knowledge to create a better future for ourselves.
I think new Belarus probably will need my experience or my support or my ideas, or maybe other people in other countries, and why not?